Okay, good morning, everyone. So I'm Teck Wai, and I would like to share with everyone about this dynamic integration with the Sitegiant ERP. So this module is quite new, and we have been testing this module since somewhere around January until today. So today we would like to share with everyone what is the new in the Sitegiant ERP, and then only we will go into what is the difference between Sitegiant ERP and the Sitegiant Unicart. Okay, hold on, I cannot move on. Okay, so our agenda today will be as per below. The first, we will go to see what is the requirement of our backend system for this integration. And then, what is the license activation that is needed to use this Sitegiant ERP? And then after that, we will go into the setup Sitegiant ERP store. And in the Sitegiant ERP store, what is the difference between the inventory and the products? Download product from the Sitegiant ERP, the matching product, how we do it, how we add the product from the Dynamo to the Sitegiant ERP, download order, and the stock adjustment. And for the last, we will go into the different between the Sitegiant Unicart and the Sitegiant ERP. Okay, so first we go into the what is the things that the Dynamo will be upload to the Sitegiant ERP and what Sitegiant ERP will be giving to us. Okay, as you can see from this middle part here, this is the arrow key where the things will be, where the method will be synced from. So from the for the first one, for the Sitegiant ERP, they will sync the SKU. SKU is the item, item list created manually in the Sitegiant ERP to the Dynamo. So from the Dynamo, we also can sync the inventory item or the stock maintenance to the Sitegiant ERP, the quantity, and we can update the selling price to the Sitegiant ERP. Then the next will be Sitegiant ERP will send us the new order and update the order status. So as you can see from here, all is the traffic from and to the Dynamo and the Sitegiant ERP, vice versa. Okay, at here, if you have any inquiry, you see at here bottom here, there is a slide number. On the bottom right hand side, there's a slide number at here, and please do jot down which slide, and then after that, at the end of the section at the Q&A, then you will come back to the slide that you have inquiry. Okay, moving on. The requirement for the integration. First, you need to have the latest version of the Dynamo as well as the Dynamo server socket. And then you have to enable this Sitegiant ERP license. So what is this ERP license? It's a new thing, sir, in the new feature in the Dynamo new version. So if you go to the Dynamo server socket, you come to the license detail in here, and then once you have this tab, you scroll down to the middle part and you'll be able to see the Sitegiant ERP. This is a new new feature to check for the license of the ERP. While for this online store, this is for the Sitegiant Unicart. So you have to enable this one, Sitegiant ERP. Okay, so moving on. How we set up the Sitegiant ERP store. We come to the setup already. And when you upgrade to the latest version, you come to this. I like to use this start because I can know all the selection whether can be expanded or not. So from here, go to the online store and then Sitegiant ERP number 5, and then go to this setup Sitegiant ERP store. And when we go into this module, this is the screen that you will be able to see. If you are using Sitegiant before, this screen is 95% is similar with the Sitegiant, but there's a 5% difference between them. So we will go into each and every one of this, all of this information, as some of you all is quite new to this, or require more information. Okay, so this is the first screen that you'll be able to see. When you scroll down to it, at the bottom is the Dynamo Process Manager setting. So we will go one by one for all of this. Okay, so moving on, we go to create a new store, a new Sitegiant store. So we fill in the store ID. This is specifically for the Sitegiant to identify your ID, or it's not from the Sitegiant. Or if you want to put the name similar as your Sitegiant ID, also can. It's up to you all. And for the effective date is when the Sitegiant start to sync with the Dynamo. Let's say, for example, today is 2nd of March. You want to start the synchronization between the Dynamo and the Sitegiant ERP. On 15th of March, then you put your date at here, 15th of March, like that. This is when your order will be start downloading. Okay, moving on. Sitegiant ERP API authentication. This is where you put your email that you registered with the Sitegiant ERP. And you can get this secret key from your Sitegiant API. Later, I will show to you where is this secret key located is. And then for the access token, at the end of this setup, then only we get this access token. Because it required to fill in all the necessary information, then only we can communicate with the Sitegiant ERP there to get this access token, like the key to enter the Sitegiant ERP store. Okay, moving on. How we get this secret key. Okay, you log into your Sitegiant website, and then you go to this setting at the bottom here, and then you go to the API. And then in the API, you'll be able to see the secret key option at here. You just need to copy this one and then put into here the secret key. At here, you just need to put in at here. Then the store email, just verify whether is it the same as what you key in. And that's all for this API authentication. Okay, so I move on to the next. And the next is the Sitegiant ERP warehouse information. Currently, we are supporting only single warehouse ID. So this ID is when we finish all the information, then only we get this warehouse ID. Okay, then the next, we move on for this shipping fee. So for this shipping fee, if you want to include this fee into your order, then you have to create a stock ID, which is meant for this shipping. Then you link it here, and after that, when every order is created into invoice, all the order at the last row will be include this shipping fee. For this tool, for this line, is about this tool. And then moving on to the next is the customer setting. At here, we have two types of the customer setting. First is the Sitegiant ERP customer. Second is the marketplace customer. So we move to this Sitegiant ERP customer. So every order that you did in the Sitegiant web store, I repeat again, Sitegiant web store, all the order that is created in there will be assigned to the Sitegiant ERP. Okay, at here. So how about the marketplace? For the marketplace channel, like for example, Lazada, Shopee, maybe you have this Lazada Singapore, so you have to assign at this marketplace customer. So when you go to this marketplace customer, you click at the dot dot dot, it's being hidden at here. You click dot dot dot, and then all the ERP, it will prompt another tab at here. So in this screen, you have to download the marketplace channel, and all the marketplace channel will be appear on this screen. So you just need to assign those channel name with the specific customer ID that you assign to. Like for example, this Shopee store. So your customer ID is the Shopee. Then all the order that belong to the Shopee will be created under customer ID is Shopee. For Lazada, then it's the Lazada. Okay, at here, there's no issue, right? So you need to assign each and every of the customer ID for every of the channel name. If, let's say, you have one order, you didn't assign any customer ID for the specific channel name, then they will take the default name from this Sitegiant ERP. Okay, that's here. Okay, so if you have any question for here, then just jot down. Then after that, you can come back. We have our specialist at here. Okay, moving on for the generate customer invoice setting. So by default, we have three order status is selected: unpaid, process, and the completed. So whenever there is an order from the Sitegiant coming in, if the order status is unpaid, then system will check, okay, your status is unpaid, so I can generate the customer invoice. Then the system will help you to generate the customer invoice at this level. If you do want to generate the customer invoice at this unpaid or the process, then you just unselect it. Then only you select this completed. So whenever there is order, you have this paid, unpaid, process, ready to share. The order will be coming in. You'll be able to see it. But the customer invoice will not be generated until your status or the order is changed to the completed. Or the marketplace channel like the Shopee integration, Lazada integration, Sitegiant integration, this Sitegiant ERP integration is the same as well for this setting. So moving on, this location is where you want to assign the invoice to. Like for example, this customer invoice, I wanted it to be generated at the HQ. HQ is where all my stock located. So all my stock will be deducted from this HQ. This is my warehouse, okay? So this is the location assignment. So currently we have only one location assignment at here. Moving on is the customer invoice prefix. So we have two options, follow order ID or the follow document prefix. If normally we will ask client to, normally we will follow the order ID. Because if you wanted to check back what is the order ID from the document number, then it will be easier for you to check. But you also can check back the order ID in the remark in the event if you want to follow document prefix. Or if you want to set this document prefix, then you have to go to this document number maintenance in the common module, setup, document number maintenance. Then you scroll down to the customer invoice. You just add a new prefix and you can assign on this screen. So every order that coming in, when the invoice is generated, it will follow the document prefix. Moving on, we go to the bottom part, Dynamo Process Manager setting. Okay, this is for the download Sitegiant ERP items, where your staff is manually create on the Sitegiant ERP there. And then after that, you can download this item to the Dynamo. Then in the Dynamo, you want the system to automatically assist you to match the SKU with the stock ID or the barcode, provided the stock ID or the barcode is same with the iSKU. Here, both must match. Like for example, in the Sitegiant ERP, I created TechY at that. Then I download to the Dynamo. I also have an item, is the TechY. Then both is the same, then it will match like this. So we have the option whether we want to match by the stock ID or match with the barcode. This is the option. So in the process manager, when you go to the setup connection, you scroll to the down here, you'll be able to see this download such as ERP items. Then after it download, system will automatically check this setting. Okay, I can go to do the matching. If you didn't untick it, if you didn't take these two options, then you have to manually do the matching in the products, which will be shared later. Okay, moving on, after the matching of the stock ID, then at here, we are downloading the product setting. Download the product setting, download the order setting. By default, we have 30 days for the order to be downloaded. If you want to download the order, which is more than 30 days, then you have to change the setting at here. So once you are done this setting at here, then you have to go to the process manager and then you add this task and then provide the recurring. Okay, moving on. After all the setting in the previous is being done, we save this screen. We save this setting and then we go to the more. We select this get access token. This is the key from the Sitegiant ERP. So when we get the access token, the system will from this loading bar. Once loading bar is generated, then it will get the access token. And it will auto fill in at this access token column here. Just for your information, this is all you just need to click once and then everything is automated. Okay, moving on. Next is the get warehouse list. So you just need to click more and then it will auto fill in for this warehouse ID. Currently, as mentioned previously, we are supporting single warehouse at the moment. So this is the setting of the Sitegiant store, Sitegiant ERP store. So we will go into this ERP store management. Okay, so this is the module for the Sitegiant ERP management. And when you open the module, this is the first screen that you'll be able to see, which is the dashboard. And in this dashboard, you can see your total order, total sales, total product, and top 5 product. You can from here to check your all the information that you needed at here. In the pie chart, the bar chart at here, you'll be able to see. But today I'm unable to share with you because I didn't have any information in here. So we go to the stock list for the store management. So first, we have this inventory. This inventory in this Sitegiant ERP, it meant all the items that is in your warehouse or your storeroom. Okay, I repeat again, you can list 1,000 items in your warehouse. You can, it's like a warehouse, you list all the items in here. This is where you keep all your items. And if you want to sell certain items, then you have to list it into the product. Let me just get an example for you. I take the industry, car industry. Okay, the product can be likened to the showroom where you want to display all the items that you want to sell, display all the car that you have. And then when you place the order, then you come to the inventory to know, to get how many cars you have. And then after that, which car you want to deliver to your customer. This is the sample of this inventory at here. Later we'll move on to the product. So on this screen, we will list all the items in the inventory and we go to this function. All the feature is quite similar with the Sitegiant. So you can download the item manually at here. You can click this button to download. And then in the event, you have two PC. You have two PC. One screen, one PC is downloading the item, the latest item already. But in the second PC, you're not able to see the new item. So you come to this refresh data to refresh your screen. And then we can match the SKU for all the listed inventory product, inventory item. And the last, we can add this item to the product, to the showroom there to sell. Okay, later we'll go in detail for all each and everyone. Okay, for the download item, it's downloading, and then refresh data is to refresh on the second PC or the third PC after the first PC is downloading the information. Then we come to the mesh or SKU. We have three options. First, we can match with the store ID and the barcode. It's similar with the setting previously, which being mentioned in your SKU is similar with the store ID. Then you can use this option to match with your store ID, or you can either match with your barcode. Then the third is the match by import file. This is the Excel file, which is available in this blog section. See my SCC in the import template. And then the file name is marketplace match SKU. So all the column, when you select this match by import file, then the new screen will be open. And in the Excel file, it may mention that here, you must consist the column of the NC stock ID and the UOM ID, or the stock barcode, marketplace SKU, marketplace store ID. So I repeat again, you can either have this stock ID and the UOM ID or barcode. Why the stock ID and the stock UOM ID is necessary? Because some of the item, like for example, I take the Coca-Cola, you can sell it by the can, you can sell it by the pack, you can sell it by the dozen or the carton. It's very different, but you want to list to the Sitegiant ERP there to sell is the carton. So in the event, if you put only Coca-Cola, the system will not know you want to match with the can, pack, carton, which one? Not sure. So that's why the stock UM ID is necessary when if you're using this stock ID to do the matching. Okay, if barcode is not necessary because each of the can, carton, pack have different barcode. So we just need the stock barcode and then the marketplace SKU and the store ID. So this is the difference between the using the stock ID or the barcode to do the matching. Moving on. After you have do the matching, then you can add the item to the product, to your showroom to sell. Okay, so when you select the item, you need to add here, select one of the item, go to the function, add to the product, fill in all the necessary information, make sure it's correct, and after that you add product. Then it will list to the product there. Please take note, for this Sitegiant ERP, only one item can be selected at one time to add to the product. If you select multiple items, then it will become the variant, even though your stock ID, your ISKU, all is different. This is the new structure by the ERP, and we are changing according to this feature. Okay, the sample on the next slide. For example, at here, I select three SKU, three items. All is different. You see, Coke, LG, and the Logi Master. When I go to the Add Sitegiant ERP product, then at here, it will appear a new box. Variation, all will be listed as a variation. This is the difference with the Sitegiant. Later at the end, I will show to you before and after for this new. So you have to add one by one, or if your item is different color and different size, then you can use this method. If not, then you have to add one by one. Moving on, product, as I mentioned earlier, This screen is the show the list of the items available to sell in the marketplace channel. It might contain all the items in the inventory. You can list all in the inventory item to this product, or selectively you select few items into the products. This is the new feature that's available from the Sitegiant ERP, and we made it into here. They have these two different between the inventory and the products. And for the products, the function that is available is the download products. It's the similar with the inventory. Yeah? So for this product, it only will download all the products in the Sitegiant ERP products, which this product is meant for the sale, not for the inventory side. Yeah? Please take note. They have separated out both our inventory and the product already. So this download product is downloaded from the product screen. And the refresh data, the functionality is similar with the inventory where you refresh the data from at the second PC after the first PC is downloaded. Okay, moving on, we go to this how to add to the Sitegiant online store inventory from the stock maintenance. So you go and select your stock ID from this stock maintenance, go to the more, add here, this add new stock to the online store, and then you select to the ERP inventory. And then you fill in all the necessary information, and you can select your stock price and the stock quantity is follow the company stock price or by the location. If you select the location, then only this location will be appear for you to change. Please take note. So if let's say your Sitegiant ERP location is not from the issue, it's from the, like, for example, Sitegiant location, you also can assign that. So you need to assign it here, the location is the Sitegiant. Moving on, we go to the next new feature from the Sitegiant ERP, stock adjustment. This is a very new feature from the Sitegiant ERP, how you adjust your stock balance in your Sitegiant ERP. First, in the Sitegiant ERP, we open this stock adjustment. It's from the inventory. Then you add the stock adjustment. Okay, when you open this screen, then you'll be able to see you want to follow either by the company stock quantity or the location quantity. Or you can select either one, and you select your location. And this pending quantity, for your information, this is the quantity from not completed order, which is, like, for example, just now, we select the status is the completed. So that is when the dynamo will generate the invoice. If your status is unpaid, so it considered not completed. So the quantity that is being listed in the paid or unpaid will be appear in this pending quantity. Okay, moving on. So for the reason of this adjustment quantity, this reason is being reported similar with the Sitegiant ERP. So they also have this only few types in this reason for us to select as listed in here. And if you want to have your own notes for this remark, then you just put in at here at this notes. This is for your own remark. You can type in free text at here. Okay, once you are done, then you add to the this Sitegiant ERP. So what will take place after we add to the Sitegiant ERP? We can go to the Sitegiant ERP there and then preview in the inventory adjustment. We go to this stock adjustment. The adjustment that we upload will be listed in here. As you can see, this SA is the document that is created from the stock adjustment earlier. So when you click it in, then the information is as such. You can see the stock ID, the sellable item is how many, and then on hand is how many quantity, and then what is the changes of the quantity. So this is one of the stock adjustment screen that you can see. While we have alternative to build the changes of this adjustment. Where is it in the Sitegiant ERP? So you can go to the inventory. Under the all inventory item, you select the specific stock item. You have to select, you have to know what is the stock ID that you make changes. If you're not sure, then you can come back to this stock adjustment, inventory adjustment at here to check back what is the item that you make the changes. So in the stock item, you go to select the specific stock item, go in, and then you go to the stock movement. In this stock movement, you'll be able to see the stock adjustment update. It being listed at here with the remark. Who is the person that did this adjustment? So if you do it through the Dynamo, then listed at here is the partner dash smart ACC solution tanker bar. Or from here, then you will be able to check, oh, this is, I did it from the Dynamo. Okay, so this is the sample from the Sitegiant, the stock adjustment, the log file that is recorded in the Sitegiant ERP. Then how we update the stock price. We go to the product, go to the function, then we select update price to Sitegiant ERP. So it will appear another screen, another window at here, and we can select either follow new price, follow company stock price, or follow location post price. So if you select the follow new price, then you'll be able to see at here, this column, new price, you can manually change at here. Then this new price, you can upload to the Sitegiant ERP. It will update from there. Or you want to follow the company stock price, is take from the stock maintenance price one. For the location post price, then you select your location, then the price will be follow the location. Okay, moving on. Next is the order. For the order, there is no changes at all on this screen. We retain as much as possible as previous Sitegiant, so that whenever the user who is familiar with the Sitegiant Unicart, when they come to this Sitegiant ERP, all the process is remain the same. We try to do that and we manage to do it in the order. So the changes that is being done is in the inventory and the product. Just for your information, all the changes is done in there, and as well for the setup, which is one time work at there. So for this week, I will very quick run through. So you can do the download order, then you refresh your data at here, or you want to select the cancel order, then you just click this one, and then all the order listed will show those that is canceled. If not, if you're not selecting this one, then all the order that is with all the status will appear in this screen. And then if you want to select the customer sales order or the customer invoice, then you just need to create this one. You select which order that you want to generate or the create, then you select this as well, the generate the customer invoice. For the report, for the channel, all is remain the same. So final, this is the final topic of the day, which is the difference between the Sitegiant ERP and the Sitegiant Unicart. Okay, first, we have three main difference between the Sitegiant ERP and the Sitegiant Unicart. The first one, the stock quantity adjustment. Or stock quantity adjustment. Second, difference between inventory and product. In the Sitegiant Unicart is called inventory, but in the Sitegiant ERP, it been separated into inventory and product. Third, the method to add the product variant from the inventory is being changed. We go through one by one. This is the three main changes, the difference between these two products. Okay, first is the stock quantity. In the Sitegiant Unicart, we have this synchronized quantity to Sitegiant. So that means in the Sitegiant Unicart, when we select this same quantity to Sitegiant, or we use the process manager to do this quantity synchronization. Then the quantity from the Dynamo, it will directly update to the Sitegiant Unicart. So the quantity can be said, you upload today, it will immediately updated, but there is no log, no screen to show that, hey, today you change this quantity. Later you change to another quantity. There's no log at here, but in the Sitegiant ERP, they require us to create a stock adjustment. So that they can keep log what is the changes being done. So at here, we didn't have any automation at the moment for this create this stock adjustment to adjust the quantity from the Dynamo to the Sitegiant ERP. All have to be done manually in this Dynamo. If you want to change the quantity in the Sitegiant ERP to be similar with the Dynamo. So you can have a look at this screen. What is the difference between these two? One is have automation. Another one for the Sitegiant ERP is the manual. You have to do this. Moving on, second difference is mentioned earlier. In the Sitegiant Unicart, we have only one product. So in the Sitegiant Unicart, the product is the your warehouse as well your showroom. So what item that you listed in the product is what you will be selling. Let's say I upload 100 products into the Sitegiant Unicart. So this 100 items is what you'll be selling in the your channel, your marketplace channel. But in the Sitegiant ERP, they have separated it out. So the inventory is for the warehouse. The product is for your showroom. The marketplace channel to synchronize and then sell in there. So this is the difference of the Sitegiant ERP, the new structure that is developed by them. So we have to upload the item into the inventory. Then from the inventory, you have to add to the product like this. Okay, there's another layer of the work that you need to accomplish if you want to sell the item in your marketplace channel. This is the difference for the product. And then for the last of this difference between the Sitegiant Unicart and the Sitegiant ERP is the way we create the stock variant. So in the Sitegiant Unicart, in the stock maintenance, when we add the stock item to the Sitegiant, provided your stock item have the article number, then the screen will automatically check for you. Okay, you have this 10 items, same article number. So I will list all the items as your variant. Then if you don't need it, then you just manually delete from this Sitegiant app product here, the variant. In the Sitegiant ERP, how we add the stock variant? As long in the inventory screen, in the inventory screen, when you add product, add item from the inventory to the product, if let's say you selected 10 items, regardless is the same SKU or different SKU, they will not check. They will treat it as the variation and then will be created as a variation in the product for you to send to the marketplace channel to sell it as a variation. This is the main difference between the Sitegiant and the Sitegiant ERP, just for your information. Okay, with this, this is the three main difference. And after here for this 40 minutes, so the whole Sitegiant ERP and the Sitegiant Unicart, the difference is not much, it's more to the setting and how you want to add item into the inventory and then go to the product. And then after that, the others is the same. So this is the main difference and the changes in the Sitegiant ERP compared to this Sitegiant Unicart. So with this, I would like to conclude today's sharing.
Extra information. In the event, if there's any inquiry from the user, whether is there any quantity will be synchronized between the Dynamo and the Sitegiant, that means we upload the quantity to the Sitegiant ERP. And the quantity from the Sitegiant ERP coming down to our Dynamo. At the moment, no. We only do one-way traffic from the Dynamo to the Sitegiant. Just for your information, I repeat again, from the Dynamo to the Sitegiant. So as you can see back this screen, this is the traffic of the each of the information that will be sent between the platform. Like I repeat again, Sitegiant ERP sending the SKU to the Dynamo, and we are also sending the inventory or the product to the Sitegiant ERP. So at here you can see it's like the two-way traffic, but in the facts, actually this is a separate functionality lah, where the SKU that you created means the item that you created manually in the Sitegiant ERP, it will be downloaded to the Dynamo for you to do the matching. And if you created the item in the Dynamo, then you upload to the Sitegiant ERP for you to do the to add into this product at there lah, for you to sell like that. Or as well, this stock quantity is one-way traffic, the selling price as well. So if let's say you update the Sitegiant ERP price, can it download to the Dynamo to be updated? No, it can't. Just for your information, it's like that. For this ERP synchronization, this is the traffic that is being written at here.